Hello students, welcome to AIIMS India online classes. This is a chemistry session. Here we are discussing about the chapter Air, Wind and Cyclones. In this session we are going to see the Olympiad practice sheet related to the chapter. Okay, let us see this practice sheet now. First let us go through the level 1 questions from this practice sheet. See the first one among those. Air, about air, certain options or properties are given here. See them once. Air occupies space. Is it correct? Yes, air occupies space. Even air exerts pressure also. Air exerts pressure in all directions. And air occupies all the available space to it. And air has fixed mass too. So these all are correct regarding air and its properties. Air occupies space, air exerts pressure, and even air has mass. As these all correct answers, what will be the correct option? Yes, all of these. Next one. Wind is. What is wind? How it is defined? Moving air is called wind. So that means the air in motion is said to be wind. Next one. When water vapor condenses around the dust particles in air, what does it form? Yes, when water vapor condenses around the dust particles, it forms mist. Mist is formed when water vapor condenses around the dust particles present in the air. It forms mist. Next one, the winds on the earth do not flow in the exact north to south or south to north direction. Why? What is the reason for this? Why these winds, they do not flow exactly from north to south or south to north? Why? Because due to the rotation of the earth, because earth will be always in rotation. So because of this, these winds won't be exactly in those directions. They get deviated a little. Okay. Next one. Which of these countries is most likely to be affected by cyclones? Observe once the countries given here. Nepal, Indonesia, Hungary, Mongolia. So if you observe once these countries, Indonesia is being in the seashore. Okay, it is at the edge of sea, on the bank of, so it will be getting mostly cyclones. It is being affected by the cyclones mostly because it is nearby the oceans and seas. Indonesia. Next one. The cold winds from the polar regions blow towards the equator, but they also move partially towards the west. Which of the following causes this? What is the reason for this movement towards partially towards west also? Actually, cold winds from polar regions blow towards the equator because at the equator, air pressure will be decreased because of hot sun. Then the temperature at the polar regions is being low still. That's why their air pressure will be greater. So now, these cool winds blow from polar regions towards to the equator. But they also move partially towards the west. What is the reason for this? Why the winds move towards west also? Because of the rotation of the earth. Here also the reason is because of the rotation of the earth. Okay. Next one. What makes rainfall as drops? So how rainfall occurs as drops? That is, the dust particles present in the air, they make them heavy and these rain falls like droplets of water. Okay. Next. In which of the following areas does the climate remain almost the same throughout the year? See, in which areas the climate will be almost similar throughout the year? It is in coastal area. The climate in that places will be almost the same throughout the year. Coastal areas means the places where nearby the oceans and seas. On what factors does the rate of evaporation depend? Rate of evaporation means the speed of the conversion of water from the water bodies into vapor form. So on which factors this evaporation depends, they're asking here. See, once temperature of the liquid, of course, if the liquid is at high temperature, rate of evaporation will be greater. If the temperature is cool, rate of evaporation will be somewhat less. Okay, it depends upon this. Next one, area of the liquid exposed to air. Yes, this is also one of the factors, because evaporation, as we know, it is a surface phenomenon. Evaporation of liquid occurs only from the surface of that liquid. So if there is more exposed surface, more amount of liquid will be evaporated at the faster rate. So area of the liquid exposed to heat also is one of the factors which affects the rate of evaporation. Next, wind blowing over the liquid. This also affects. If it is a wind in the blowing moment, if wind blows faster, evaporation also will be faster. For this, we can say one example, when one glass of water is poured on floor. So for the complete evaporation of that water, some time it will take. And when you switch on the fan in that place, the water will evaporate at faster rate than the normal condition. Means wind blowing also affects the rate of evaporation. So these three are the factors which are affecting rate of evaporation. Now we can say this is the correct answer. Right, next one. In which of the following cases does evaporation take place? At which places evaporation takes place? Conversion of vapors into liquid state. What do we call evaporation means? Conversion of liquid into vapor state. But conversion of vapors into liquid is called condensation. Liquefaction of compressed air is also just like the condensation only. Liquefaction and condensation. In both these processes, gaseous substance converts into liquid state. That is not. Drying of wet clothes. Yes, here evaporation takes place. When wet clothes being dried, the water present in the clothes will convert into vapor, and hence that enters into the atmospheric air. So the clothes become dry. So the drying of clothes involves evaporation of water. And conversion of solid to gas. Actually, the conversion of solid into gas is called sublimation, not evaporation. So correct answer is no, drying of wet clothes. Next one, what causes convection currents in air? What is the reason for the convection currents in the air being continuously moving from one place to another place? The reason for this is the heat on the surface of the earth. Earth is being heated at different temperatures in different places. The place where the temperature is high, in that place, low pressure area is created. Now, the air from high pressure area rush to occupy that low pressure area place, and hence, convection currents of air are created. Okay, that is because of the heating on the surface of the earth. Next one. Which one of the following is a natural calamity? See, some certain calamities are mentioned here. Which of them is natural calamity, which is not done by the human beings, which is occurring naturally by the nature? Landslides, forest fire, flood, these all come under natural calamities. There is no influence of human beings on that. They occur naturally. So we can say these all are natural calamities. Okay, next one. Thunderstorm is more common in which one of the following areas? So, in which areas thunderstorms are being more common? These are mostly observed in the places where hot and humid tropical place is there. So, in the hot and humid tropical areas, these thunderstorms are most common. They occur mostly in those areas, hot and humid tropical areas. Okay? Next one. Loud sound followed by lightning in the sky is called which one of the following? What it is called? Loud sound followed by lightning. That is called thunderstorm. We also might have observed before raining. We observe loud sounds will come from the sky with a certain flash lighting. Those are called thunderstorms. Next one. A violent twisting funnel of wind is called. So what is that called? A violent twisting funnel which is destroying all the things around it is called a tornado. The twisting air is called tornado. Next. A cyclone is expand up to 30 to 35 kilometers. Isn't it? Of course it might be. Now the center of the cyclone is called. What do we call the center part of the cyclone? Where the air pressure is being very low and it will be calm area at the center. That is called eye of the cyclone. The center part of the cyclone is called eye of the cyclone. There the air pressure will be less. Next, ozone layer of the earth atmosphere protects us from the harmful ultraviolet rays emitted by the sun. Now, this ozone layer is found in which one of the following layers of the atmosphere? We know atmosphere is segregated into five regions. One of them is troposphere, where we are living. Okay, that is called troposphere. And the next layer after the troposphere is stratosphere. So in this stratosphere, this ozone layer is existing. So this is a second layer of the earth from the earth surface. Stratosphere. In this stratosphere, this ozone layer is existing, which is protecting us from the harmful ultraviolet radiation emitting from the sun. Okay, that is stratosphere. Next one. The chemical formula of ozone. What is the chemical formula of ozone? Ozone is one of the forms of element oxygen. So its molecular formula is O3. Okay, ozone is O3. Next, dash maximum temperature of the day is observed. Means at which time maximum temperature of the day is observed? Generally in the afternoon time. In the afternoon time, maximum temperature of the day is observed. Now, dash causes all the changes in the weather. The main cause for the changes in the weather is sun. Due to sun, these all changes are occurring in the weather. Now, let us see some level 2 questions also from this practice sheet. See the first question. Earthing is provided in buildings and tall constructions to protect it from. Why this earthing is given to the buildings and tall constructions? To protect those from the leakage of electric current. Okay, to avoid the shocking the person who are living in those. To avoid shock for those people, this earthing is given to the buildings. Okay, to protect from the leakage of electric current. Next, the winds from the oceans carry water and bring rain. So this is called, what it is called, bringing rains from the winds which are caused from the oceans. The winds from the oceans carry water vapor in the form of clouds and they convert into rain. That is called monsoon. It occurs at a particular period in the year in different places. Okay, that is called monsoon. Next one. Which of the following is the first sign of an approaching cyclone? What do we observe when cyclone is approaching to our area? What is the first sign from this cyclone approaching? That is powerful water waves. In the oceans we observe powerful water waves. Okay, because of these high pressure winds, the water in the oceans creates high powerful waves. That indicates approaching of a cyclone even though the cyclone is very far away from the land, these waves indicates that this wave, the air blowing from that cyclone, creates high powerful waves in the ocean at the shore. So that indicates the approach of cyclone in few hours, few minutes. Okay, first indication is powerful water waves in the water bodies like oceans. Next one, high speed winds are accompanied by, what will come along with the high speed winds? We know there, that is formed because of reduced pressure. So the wind always moves from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. So this wind speed is because of the pressure difference between the two areas in the air. The air from the high pressure area to, it rushes to the place where the air, low air pressure is existing. Because of that, this high speed winds are created. Okay. Next one. Wind currents are generated due to the, what is the reason for generation of wind currents? What is it? Yes, the shape of the earth. As the shape of the earth is being spherical, the temperature or the heat absorbed from the sun will be different at different places. So because of this, wind currents are occurring. As one place is becoming hot, in that area low pressure is created. So at certain places temperature will be still low, in that area air will be with the high pressure. So wind always moves from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. In that way, wind currents are generated. So that is because of the shape of the earth. A typhoon is essentially, what is a typhoon? It is one of the forms of cyclone. Typhoon is a cyclone. Next. Oh, already answer is given here. Development and moment of cyclones are studied by the Indian Meteorological Department. These people, the scientists working in that department, will study the weather and climatic conditions at a particular place. They give prior indications to the people about these cyclones and storms, about these all. So they give cautions to the people in prior. On blowing air into a balloon, the size of the balloon increases because air exerts pressure. Air exerts pressure on the walls of the container in which it is stored. So if it is blown into a balloon, this air inside the balloon exerts pressure on the walls of the balloon, and hence it becomes bulged. So we say the size of the balloon increases. Next one. Which of the following is the safest way to protect yourself from lightning? Which will be the safest? Already it is given. Let us see once the options are given. Run to an open field. Is it safe? No. Open an umbrella for cover. No, it is also not safe because that umbrella might be having metallic rod at the middle that may attract the electrical power from the thunders. So that is not safe. Take shelter under long tree, under trees. This is also not safe, because sometimes trees also in the wet condition, they attract these thunders. So that are also not safe. So squat low on the ground. Staying low on the ground is safe thing to do when lightning. Okay, next one. Okay, that's about the practice sheet 2. The Olympiad practice sheet based upon the chapter Air, Wind and Cyclones. Okay, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our YouTube channel AIIMS Today and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates. Please visit our website also, that is aimstoday.in, for other information regarding online classes, quizzes, live worksheets, do-it-yourself activities, English classes, reasoning classes, even for coding classes also.